Now, a very common illustration which is very useful to understand the field of view is the minimum length of mirror required to see self image. Say, we are given with a large size vertical mirror which is placed on horizontal ground, and in front of the mirror, say, an observer is standing. And in this mirror, we can see if observer is standing at a distance x, at the same distance behind the mirror x, the image of this observer will be obtained, which is of same size as that of observer because it is a plane mirror. In this situation, say if this observer is willing to see his full image, we are required to find the minimum length of mirror which is required. Obviously, if the mirror is full, certainly he'll be able to see the full image. Now, to see his full image, in the field of view of observer, the complete image, the shoes of his image to the hairs of his image must be in the field of view of this observer. So, if we create the field of view by joining the eye of observer to the extremities of the image like this, then we can say if this is the field of view of observer, then he'll be able to see the complete image. So here, if this image is broken from these two points A and B, and the mirror which is above and below the segment AB is removed, even after that we can see he'll be able to see the complete image. If the height of observer is h, then the height of image will also be h, as in case of plane mirror the image obtained is exactly of same size. Then in this situation we can see if these points are A and B, if eye of observer is E and say these points are C and D, which are the top and bottom points of the image, then here we can write in triangle ECD. In this triangle, AB is a line which is parallel to the base and which is at the half altitude of this triangle ECD. So, in triangle ECD, we can directly write that AB is equals to half of CD. That basic triangle properties you already studied. And here CD is H, so this must be H by 2. This is the minimum length of the mirror which is required if it is placed at this position AB. Then through this mirror, observer will be able to see his complete image. So, here we can write down a note that minimum length of mirror required for a man to see his complete image is half of his height. If his height is h, then h by 2 is the minimum length of mirror size required through which he'll be able to see his complete image. This is quite a useful concept you must keep in mind. If we just wish to see how he's able to see, then we can directly write that the light ray which is originated from the topmost point will be reflected from the edge of mirror and gets into his eye. So, he feels that the light rays coming from the image of his ears. Similarly, light rays from shoes will incident on the edge of the mirror and will reach his eyes, and he'll feel that the light rays are coming from the image of the shoe. Now, in this situation, all those light rays which are originating from various points within the body of this observer will get reflected from the mirror AB and finally gets into the eye of observer, and he'll feel that the light rays are coming from the image of his body. That's why he's able to see his complete image. This logic is also very useful in handling various kind of numerical applications.